when I came to Belle Vue, my aim was to, as an individual, is that I came with quite a bit of experience, having been an agricultural teacher at the level of the secondary school, and a practicing farmer from as long as I can remember. And I felt that I needed to contribute, so Belle Vue was just a natural transformation to move into. One of the things I brought to the board was the whole question of ensuring that you arrive at consensus decisions. If you agree on consensus, it means that we all take responsibility for our successes, because we never look at failure. Every time something doesn't work, let us see it as an opportunity to do something with it. And that's the attitude we have. The challenges was lack of water. And so sometimes by January, February, you have the drought, the natural drought coming in. We were able to run workshops and introduce those farmers to in drip irrigation. It had good impact, because you have vehicles going to and from, and you have someone growing tomatoes in the middle of the drought, January, February, and you come and you call, you say, boy, that's really looking green. And people started to wonder, because they don't see overhead sprinkler. And that was the catch. And then people would stop and ask, but why? And they said, look, that's where it gets the water. It gets the water in the soil, directly in the roots. If you can store 1,000 gallons of water, if there is a shortage of, from Wasco, you have storage. It means that you can farm. And we are trying to introduce this on in the Delce region. And one guy has embraced it. And he said to a lot of the farmers, now I am able to grow year round, because when for some reason the canal doesn't have water, I have 800 gallons in my tank. Well, mulch came around after we had done the training in composting. Then we understood then that it had to be a package. And again, we were talking about building resilience, and we were working in extremely dry areas. Example, La Faga. When the program started, every time you pass on the roadside, piles of grass. When we introduced mulching, you couldn't find grass by the roadside. What you'd see is pickups pack and putting the grass in bags and carrying it away. I mean, that was just fascinating, because we at the level of Belle Vue were saying, boy, that's exactly what you call transformed technology. Here was something that was being wasted by the road. The playing fields. People were going on the playing fields and collecting it. While the guys are cutting, people are collecting it, housewives. Because we had got the message out there that, hey, this is something you can use in your backyard to do all kinds of things for you. And as a result, people were just fascinated. And we were able to see the benefits of that mulch program by the amount of production we're getting at Belle Vue. Now we've come up with a brilliant idea to use water tanks. Those tanks that is used to bring in various things at the brewery and elsewhere. Now we're using that for our storage of the waste, and then we use vehicle tube to collect the gas. And you attach your stove to this. We will be doing a manual in terms of what it's going to cost, and there's no size, and the simple technology. We're still experimenting, but at the minute we already have gas, and pretty soon we'll be attaching our stove, and then we'll be able to sell that technology. And it is not just for pigs, but persons can do it for all. The pig is the fastest, but then you can do it for everything that rots, including plant material. Now we can sit around the table and design and write proposals for anything, because we've become very good at it, and we've also become very good at evaluating it, designing and developing evaluation tools. And these are skills we didn't have before. So now we have it, and now we can pass it on to other persons. In the past, we'd have had to get a consultant to implement that project. Now we were able to, everything we have spoken for today, the proposal for them was designed by us implemented by us, evaluated by us. And when some of our funders that have come in, they see it, we explain. So there's a lot of, there's good understanding of the value of this project. Well, we don't call it a project because it has life. At first, it has no end. So we call it an initiative. An initiative like this, they're bound to be ups and downs. You have successes and you have not too good successes. But what we have always done at Belle Vue is to make sure that we take, every time something didn't work, we looked at it as an opportunity. And some of the great lessons that we learned was one of the Belle Vue's ability to build partnerships.